Connie, I know God's going to see you through this heartache. Remember, you're not alone anymore. He's with you. He said he'd never leave you nor forsake you. Okay? I want to give you my phone number, and you call me if you need me. And if not, I'll come by and see you tomorrow.
But that's Christmas Eve, Brother Bill. Don't you need to be home with your family?
John, you don't understand. You are my family. We're brothers and sisters in Christ. And God and we are going to see this through together, okay? I'll see you tomorrow, buddy.
Okay. Take care. I'm looking forward to seeing you tomorrow, Brother Bill.
Okay.
Reverend Bledsoe, do you think you could stay here with my mother while Sean and I go try to find our real father? Yeah, Sean's gone home to get some things ready, but then we're going to go. I think it's time that we're all honest with each other, and I believe we all need to ask for forgiveness.
I'm so glad to hear that. That is, y'all have a safe here.
I wonder how that Bible got in my car. Mary Jane Breedlove, May 1969.
Thank you. You see, Mr. Hughes, you don't know us, and to tell you the truth, we only learned of you yesterday. And, well...
What my brother's trying to say, Mr. Hughes, is, this is Sean, your son, and I'm Beth, your daughter.
Well, thank God he's answered my prayer and sent him to see me. Brother Bill, come quickly. I want you to meet my son and daughter.
Hey,
hi there.
This is great. Beth?
Nice to meet you.
Sean? All right. Praise the Lord. He does answer prayers, doesn't he, Johnny?
Yes, he does.
Hey, my wife sent a basket of food over to for you, but there's enough food for everybody. So, hey, just dig in and eat all you want to there.
Thank you.
Man, this is such good news. Man, how'd you hear about it?
My mother, she got sick a while back, and, well, she was saved and wanted to tell us, and it just took her a while.
That's great.
Your mother's sick?
Yeah. She'll be okay, though. Reverend Bledsoe's staying with her until we return.
Who's this?
Mom!
What are you doing here?
You should be in the hospital.
They released her from the hospital, and she insisted on coming. Sit down easy.
Virginia, you're just as lovely as ever. A little older.
Johnny, I'm sorry I did you like this. I should have stayed and helped you through it all. But I've asked God to forgive me. And now, I'm asking you, Johnny, will you forgive me?
Virginia, I forgive you. You see, God has opened my eyes and my heart as well. He sent Preacher Bill to help me to understand that when trouble comes, you've got to be prepared for it. And you've got to have someone to lean on and someone you can trust in. And that someone is God. Brother Bill, can you read that Christmas story now?
I sure can, Johnny. And it came to pass in those days there went out a decree of Caesar Augustus that the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius, the governor of Syria, and all that went to be taxed, everyone to his own city, and Joseph also went up into Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed of Mary, his housewife, being great with child. And so it was that she brought first her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in that same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were very sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
Beth, Sean, I'm going to get Reverend Bledsoe to take me home. You stay tonight with your dad and get to know him.